Hey guys, Silent Xiao here. Welcome back to another Utah Macross Gacha video with me. So before we begin, let me do a rough explanation on what this particular gacha video is going to be about. We are going to definitely pull Cheryl's brand new gacha for her new swimsuit costume. And of course, we're going to test out another theory that was introduced by another of my close friends in the States who has been playing Utah Macross alongside with me for two over years. Alright, so basically he did some trial and errors regarding the specific time of day when it comes to pulling the gacha, and you probably might get a way better luck than you probably would getting doing your pulls at the usual time that you pull your gachas during your own day and periods of time within your own country itself. Alright, so basically this is the time periods that we are going to try out. Currently, I am doing the 7 to 9 PM Japan time slot right now as of I'm recording this video. It is currently 7:38 PM in Japan. And of course, the other time slot, if you want to take note, if you're a morning person, it is 2 to 4 AM Japan time, which is basically very rare for the Japanese people to be playing this game because that's the period where they are sleeping, unless somehow or other they are doing construction work in their own country or maybe a graveyard shift job and they are probably awake at that point of time. That's probably when is the best time they're going to, you know, pull gachas for themselves if they are capable of doing so while doing your job. Alright, so take note of the timing. It is 2 to 4 AM and of course 7 to 9 PM Japan time. So if you guys need to go and figure out what time it is for yourself in your own country, please go check out the world clock and compare the time periods and of course how many hours you have to deduct or add into your time zone just to meet within this criteria itself. Now in the past, we did do theory tests on timing as well, but I did not do the entire 24-hour span of tests. I basically did a 5-minute test, 10-minute test, 1-hour test, you know, the differences between each hour per pool, you know, that kind of stuff. So this time round, we have somehow of a estimated time zone within the 24-hour period. So that's 2 to 4am and at 7 to 9pm Japan time. I have to repeat myself because just in case you guys didn't pay close attention enough during my video itself. Alright, so let's go and do this test. I have enough basically just for a single template pool for Cheryl. I just need an episode plate with her costume points and then I can do an unlock with the episode ops in the future. And yeah, so since it's discounted, it's just 300 singing stones as promised by Dana. And let's take a look at Cheryl's episode plate to see whether her episode plate is on the level of Valkyrie's episode plate or is it as bad as Ranka's and as seen in the last Utah Macross gacha video that I created. Alright, so tap the episode plate and immediately, okay, we'll take it to the second page first. So it's active skill, score up, so it's a center episode plate that actually helps with gaining high score. So for 10 seconds your score is boosted by 100% up. Pretty normal. We have not seen an active skill that is actually beyond 100%, which is going to be an awesome thing if finally Dana decides to release an episode plate that probably might boost 120% up in score by an active skill alone. Alright, so life skill, score up. Wow, okay. It's a B rank score up ability, but you know, to have a center skill ability affecting high score and a life skill that also affects high score, I think this is probably one of the first few times that we can actually find episode plates like this. Even though the life skill is of a B rank and the percentage is kind of low, which is only at 20%, that's kind of a bummer, but pretty nice to have around. But I don't think anyone will probably use this as a life skill support. There are definitely episode plates that are way better than this. Alright, so take note of the 4 divas equipable with this episode plate in case maybe within the other 3 they are one of your favorite divas that you definitely want to have this episode plate to use for within your arsenal of collections. Alright, no special notes attached to the episode plate, so kind of a bummer. All the swimsuit costume episode plates have no special notes attached to it so far. We still have Basara, Milane, and Min Mei upcoming, so hopefully one of the 3 of them might break the chain or maybe just you know, follow along suit. But hopefully enough, their episode plates might have better stats as compared to Ranka's, which was kind of depressing because her total score was only around 2,500, while the rest of the Valkyrie members all had, 2,800 or more, or was it 3,000? I can't recall. So, all right, so let's take a look. Oh, it was 3,000. So Cheryl's episode plate is the same as Ranka, depressingly low total score, 3582, and of course focusing on Soul. In the last episode I didn't mention which stat was being focused, but looking at the numbers you guys definitely are smart enough to tell which is the focus score or stats that is on the episode plate itself. Center skill S rank Soul up, unit Soul is boosted by 90% up, so fantastic center skill. Definitely a fantastic episode plate. If you don't have anything better than this one that has this, sad to say, mediocre total average score, there are definitely episode plates that are better in total score stats as this one. There is also a center episode plate that is mainly used for high score achieving purposes. So guys, if you guys don't have anything better than this, definitely you might want to try aiming to get a copy, which is what we're here to test out, to see whether we can boost our luck with this time period that somehow or rather has some miraculous boost in rate up. Alright, so guys, we're gonna do a single template pool. The time is currently 7:44 PM as of this point of time in this video recording. We're gonna pull a single template pool. I still have Ranka out in the main menu screen, as some of you guys have mentioned in the last video in the comments section down below, mentioning about what how much of a belief you have in this theory where your diva, your divas in your team setup and the main screen divas, that kind of stuff, don't really affect the rate up or does affect, you know, you guys have your opinions. Of course we have to test this out because these are all just theories, there is no hard evidence proof. Of course that's what these videos are all about, we are trying to make some proof out of it or evidence to show that there is some kind of possibility that these things does affect the gacha itself. So alright, I have Cheryl out on the main screen. I'm not gonna change it to I don't have Cheryl out on the main screen, I have Ranka out on the main screen. I'm not gonna change Ranka to Cheryl. We're just gonna try and prove that point as well. Maybe it is definitely the time period that is the one affecting the gacha's rate up instead, and instead of the diva on the main screen or even your team setup that is the one doing the job. Alright, so let's do this guys, single template pool. Of course we definitely want to take note of the loading at the bottom left hand corner. If it takes a long time to load, definitely means there's a chance of brand new episode plates appearing within the template pool itself. The plates, I mean the Valkyries and all this is just a bonus animation. Oh, we do get a golden orb straight off the bat. So definitely a 5-star episode plate is granted. Ooh, and we have 3 red boxes on the second blink. So no evolution on the first plate of the red box. We have seen scenarios where the second and third episode plate does evolve. But we did had a video created sometime in the past where we kind of proved that if the first plate didn't evolve, the rest would not evolve. But apparently, I think Dana changed up the formula, as you can see right now, the plate evolved for the second one. So I'm not too sure whether that first video that we disprove of this theory is relevant anymore. Maybe after Dana went to the second anniversary update, they kind of changed their formula, and of course things have gotten a bit more interesting in terms of gacha pools. Alright, so we did pull a second 5-star episode plate from one of the red boxes evolving. And of course, definitely you can tell I had Ranka out. Was it? Yeah, Ranka out to evolve the episode plate instead of Cheryl. So the main diva on the main screen doesn't seem to really do anything. Okay, so we do get some pretty old episode plates. No new plates for Cheryl, I suppose. Hopefully I do get the message. There we go, I do get one episode plate that comes with Cheryl's brand new costume. points, so that's not too bad. But okay, I do get an old episode plate evolving. That's pretty nice as well. Two episode plates evolving, so that's pretty good in my books, because it's always nice to have fully evolved 5-star episode plates to be ready for use in terms of high score achieving. Because right now, the current event, I am struggling like crazy. There are a buttload of star element episode plates or yellow element episode plates, whichever one you guys refer them to as. But the score set up on my collection of yellow star element plates are horrendous, even though I am running low on resources to power them up, because the yellow resources are very, very rare, and because they now keep producing more and more yellow element episode plates rather than the blue and the pink ones, which is pretty annoying. So guys, what do you guys say with this video evidence of this gacha pool during the time period of 7 to 9pm Japan time? Does this kind of prove that, you know, this particular time period, when you pull your gachas, there is a higher chance of getting better pulls? The plates are old for my case, but you know, considering that my last few videos have been horrendous luck, I don't know. It could be just because I had terrible luck in the past, and then this current one is finally the chance for me to have my luck reversed and starting to get better. I can't say for sure that this particular gacha pool can prove that theory right. So that's where you guys come in. Let me know in the comments down below, how are your pools like during this time zone periods? I repeat myself again, it is 2 to 4am and 7 to 9pm Japan time. Please make sure you check the world clock just in case you get your time zones kind of mixed up. Alright, so let me guys know what are your results in your gacha pools. Maybe screenshot them, share it to my Facebook page where I'm posting this YouTube video up. Maybe just comment down below on the YouTube channel as well. Let me know, how are your results like? Have you tried this theory out for yourself? And of course, is it consistent for you in this case? Personally, for myself, I don't really believe in such a theory, but there are other gacha games out there that does have this kind of mechanics installed into the game, where a specific time period is, you know, the best time period to pull gachas and all that kind of stuff. It might be the same for Ultima Cross, but that is just a theory. A game theory. No, I'm not gonna steal anything from MatPat. So anyway guys, thank you guys for joining me once again for another Ultima Cross gacha video. Let me know by hitting the like button down below if you appreciate all the information I shared. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed just yet. And I'll see you guys in the next Ultima Cross gacha video. Until then, bye!